Dear friends, welcome back. So we are here for a demonstration of wing and tail combination. As we derived in our lecture, we noticed that when we have similar wing and tail, identical wing and tail separated by a distance, assuming a minimum downwash, no interference at the tail, we figured out the neutral point to be at the midpoint of the distance between aerodynamic center of wing and aerodynamic center of tail. That is what we have derived. So we are now going to prove that whether our derivation is true or not. So first of all, let me show you the configuration. So we have two identical rectangular wings, if you can see here. So they are about 2.4 meter span, okay, and a chord of, so you can see in the side view, so with a chord of 0.23 meters. So the aspect ratio is close to 12, no? So, and then this entire setup weighs about 1.8 kgs. Right now, so I just want to show you the aerodynamic centers of wing and tail. Okay. So we have our friends here, Kirubakaran and, yeah, Kiruba, come here, Santosh and Prabhajit. So Sampat and Prabhajit, yeah. So he is Kiruba and Sampat, who has made this model with the help of Prabhajit, yes. And yeah, Santosh also helped them. Thank you for that. And I'll be taking their help to catch this model. Once we throw it, I'm not sure whether this model is going to sustain the first landing or not. If it sustains, then we'll also demonstrate in unstable mode. Say if the CG is behind the neutral, when the CG is behind the neutral point. Okay. So say this is my 0.23 approximately. No, this bit curved, right? So 0.23 meters is the chord, since due to curvature it is bit more here. Now we have figured out the aerodynamic center of the wing, or the first wing, let us say, is at this particular joint. No? You can see this particular joint. So this is the aerodynamic center of this wing, and then the aerodynamic center of this tail is somewhere here. No? It is marked here, aerodynamic center of tail. So here, this is the aerodynamic center of tail. Right, so I am now trying to locate the neutral point, which is midway between these two. Okay, so can you help me to hold it from there? Yes, of course, there will be some inaccuracy. That's the reason why I will take CG a bit more ahead of the neutral point as well as a bit behind the neutral point. This may not be so accurate because of these measurement errors. So place it on top of this. Yes, this is approximately 176. So half of this 176, so 176 is the separation between AC of wing and AC of tail. So half of 176, how much? 88, yeah. So 88 is where this neutral point is located. We have a marking here which is close to 88 centimeters with respect to the aerodynamic center of wing. So that's a midway between these two points. So now I'll try to throw this out. Okay. Yeah. So let's check what is the current CG of this model. So I'm getting inside this model. Okay. So this is slightly behind the neutral point right now. I'd like to add some more weight so that it becomes ahead of it. It'll go ahead of this aerodynamic center, the neutral point for this entire configuration. So do you have weight with you? Yeah, there will be a lot of interference because of this strings, but still we'll try to fly this model. Okay, so bring it back. So now what will be, let me check the CG again. So this is definitely ahead of the neutral point right now. Okay, so this is somewhere here. I'm able to balance this somewhere here, so ahead of the neutral point. So now according to our derivation, now the CG is ahead of the neutral point. It has to fly in a stable mode. Let's see whether it is able to or not, right? So Kirba, you may come front, bit front. So if this model sustains the first landing, then we can demonstrate in unstable mode as well. Oh, it is able to, right? It's able to glide. So I'll try to throw it again. It's able to glide properly, right? So our derivation is correct. Right now it is just maybe 2 centimeters ahead of the neutral point for this configuration. So we'll try one more time and then see. Okay, is the angle okay? So I'll try now to demonstrate in the unstable mode. So for that I need to shift the CG behind the neutral point. So what I do is, I'll try to take out these weights. Okay. So and see where is the current CG location. Okay. It's behind. So this is where I'm able to balance right now. So this is the place where I'm able to balance the model. So which is the current CG location. So this is where the neutral point is. My index finger is pointing at the neutral point. And my thumb is almost close to the CG, current CG, without added weights. So which is behind the neutral point. Now Kirba, I think, yeah, I'll try to throw this. So now the CG is behind the neutral point, way behind the, see that. So since because of its inertia, you can't see that flipping, but still it is not able to glide properly. You can see that again. We'll try to throw it again. Maybe when we drop it from a higher altitude, you'll be able to appreciate. See, yeah. So it's not happening. The CG is behind the neutral point. You can see it's not able to fly in a stable mode. Okay. So it is important for us to make sure that the CG is ahead of the neutral point, and we also figured out that the neutral point for identical wings lies at the midpoint of their midpoint of the separation of aerodynamic centers of the two wings, right? So now I'm on top of this ATC. I'm trying to throw this. So we are now again flying it in a stable mode. The CG is ahead of the aerodynamic neutral point here. Yeah. Okay. Done. Thank you.